I put out my first USG video over 8 years ago, and Ubiquiti enthusiasts have been calling for an updated version for almost as long. Something that's powerful enough for all of the cool new UniFi network features that also doesn't break the bank. So now it seems that the long wait is over, as Ubiquiti has announced and released the UXG-Lite, also simply known as the Gateway Lite. The Gateway Lite is a compact and powerful UniFi gateway that boasts 10 times the routing performance of the original USG and features the sexy UniFi design aesthetic that we've all come to expect, which is quite an improvement over the old model. But does it live up to the hype? Let's take it for a test drive and find out. Have you ever felt overwhelmed by the complexities of configuring VPNs or setting up your network to be as secure and reliable as possible, and just wish that someone could handle it all for you? Well, look no further. Introducing Rogue Support by Crosstalk Solutions, your go-to resource for wireless, networking, and yes, even those tricky VPN setups. Our expert technicians are standing by to help you with your networking needs, and are especially familiar with how to configure your network for secure and reliable remote access. And the best part? We adapt to your schedule and we work seamlessly with any vendor's equipment. Each one of our Rogue technicians has been handpicked by me, not just for their top-tier technical prowess, but also for their unparalleled customer service. So check out Rogue Support on the web at rogue.support, and for a limited time, you can get 25% off your first engagement with coupon code ROGUE. Trust Rogue Support, you won't be disappointed. All right, so first thing we need to do is get it out of the box, and this is my first time seeing this device. It was just released yesterday. I got it overnight shipping. I did pay for this model myself, and there we have the Gateway Lite. Now, it measures about 4 inches by 4 inches by about 1 inch thick, and in the box we have the Gateway Lite and a power adapter, and that is apparently it. The Gateway Lite is quite a simple device. It's powered up with a 15-watt USB-C cable, and it features 1 gigabit WAN port and 1 gigabit LAN port. The CPU is a dual-core ARM Cortex A53, and it has 1 gig of DDR3L RAM. Now, this is double the RAM of the USG, and I assume that it's also a more powerful CPU, but I wasn't able to actually find the CPU specs of the original. There's also one significant difference. The original USG had 2 separate LAN ports, and the Gateway Lite now only has a single LAN port, but to me, this really isn't too big a deal. I mean, with VLANs, network switches, the need for additional ports directly on the firewall is greatly reduced. And let me also get ahead of all of the comments from people who are inevitably going to complain that this device doesn't have enough ports, or the port should be 2.5 gigabit, or it should have PoE, or it should shoot rainbows out of the LAN port. Well, this is now UniFi's $129 entry-level gateway appliance. If you have a multi-gigabit internet connection, guess what? You're gonna need a more powerful gateway. If you need an 8-port switch on board or power over Ethernet, then you're gonna need a different device. And UniFi has all sorts of different equipment for different needs. This one is for vanilla installations with less than gigabit internet connections. It's for users who don't have super strong networking needs, but want to start dipping their toes into the UniFi ecosystem. And if you really do want a router that can shoot rainbows out the Ethernet ports, then I guess you're just gonna have to wait for Corsair to start making routers. All right, so back to the Gateway Lite. This is not a UniFi OS console, which means that you're going to have a separate UniFi network controller running UniFi network version 8.0.7 or higher. We'll talk about that a little bit more in this video. In this case, I'm gonna use this CloudKey Gen 2, which is gonna be powered up by this USW Lite 8 PoE switch. All of this equipment is in a factory default state, so let's get started with a very simple UniFi setup using the Gateway Lite. Okay, so let me get my switch out of the box because we do need to PoE power the Gen 2 CloudKey. This is a brand new switch. All right, switch is powered up. Let's power up the Gateway Lite next. Oh, it comes with a nice long 6-foot cable, I like that. And now we need to plug in our internet. So for internet, I'm just gonna use T-Mobile home internet. I've got a connection right here. We're gonna plug that into the WAN port of the Gateway Lite. And then I need two cables. I need one cable from the Gateway Lite to the switch, and I need a second cable from the switch to the CloudKey. Okay, there we go. Everything is powered up and should be booting. And so I'm gonna get this adopted via UniFi. I probably have to update this CloudKey to 8.0.7, and then I will come back and we'll talk about the Gateway Lite a little bit more. Setup of the Gateway Lite was very straightforward. The CloudKey that I'm using here was so old that it had to go through 4 rounds of updates to get current. Also, I had mentioned to you earlier that you need to have UniFi Network version 8.0.7 or higher, but turns out that's incorrect since my CloudKey updated to version 7.2.97 and I was still able to adopt the Gateway Lite. When looking through UniFi, by default, teleport is enabled, which I think personally should not be the default. You should have to specifically turn that on. I also noticed that the deep packet inspection is enabled by default, but the intrusion detection and intrusion prevention are disabled. But overall, installing the Gateway Lite is going to give you a fully vanilla UniFi network installation. In terms of temperature, the Gateway Lite runs about where you would expect for these new devices, which is just about 125 to 130 degrees Fahrenheit. And noise-wise, since it's completely fanless, I mean, the reason that it gets hot on the bottom is because the bottom is basically a heatsink here. And since it's fanless, there's no noise at all. It's just completely silent. So then here's the million-dollar question. Where does the Gateway Lite fit in the lineup of UniFi products? Right, with only a single WAN and LAN port, as well as only gigabit Ethernet, this is an entry-level device. But to have a bare minimum UniFi setup with the Gateway Lite, you're looking at a decent amount of money. This setup that I have here is the Gateway Lite, the 8-port Lite switch, a CloudKey Gen 2, and we're gonna also throw in a U6 Lite access point. This is gonna cost you just over $400. So if you have vanilla entry-level network needs, why would you buy all of this instead of just buying the Dream Router, which basically has all of that combined into one unit for less than half the price? Well, with this Gateway Lite setup, you definitely have some more versatility in terms of where you can place your equipment, and there's, of course, always something to be said about not putting all of your eggs in one basket. So is the performance way better with the Gateway Lite? Well, that I really actually don't know, but if you're installing UniFi into a vanilla network environment with a sub-gigabit internet connection, either of these setups should work just fine. That's gonna be well within the realm of what these can handle. So here's where I really like the Gateway Lite. If you are an installer like me, and you have a centrally hosted UniFi controller, either Ubiquiti's official UniFi hosting or something like Hostify, then I would prefer to install the Gateway Lite setup for my customers, which would mostly be small business customers. This is gonna give you the most flexibility in terms of planning out your deployments on a per customer basis, and you just have a single UniFi controller to keep track of in terms of keeping the software up to date and maintaining backups. Plus, it's gonna be much more cost effective than installing a full, like, Dream Machine Pro setup. You can also keep spare gateways, switches, and access points at the ready in case of any failures. But that, of course, is just my opinion of the Gateway Lite. What's your opinion? Let me know down in the comments below. Would you buy this for your home, or would you standardize on this equipment for customers? I'd love to hear what you think. And if you'd like to keep this party going, I have hand-selected 2 videos on the right here for you to watch next. The top video is my recent overview of what's new in UniFi 8.0.7, and the bottom video is my tutorial on all of the different VPN options within UniFi Network.